Hey, I'm Ernesto, I make Tech and Breaks, and today we're gonna talk about acoustic treatment. Start saving up your egg cartons, because I'm gonna run you through the key elements that would make your home studio the perfect production and mixing environment. Before we get into this video, I think I gotta tell you, you forgot to leave a like on it. The first thing we're gonna cover is the difference between acoustic treatment and soundproofing. Soundproofing is used to reduce bleed of sound from one room to the other. Acoustic treatment is used to reduce reverbs, echoes, bass buildups, standing waves, and room notes. The goal in our case is to make the sound you hear from your listening position as flat as possible, making your mixes translate correctly. Let's talk about desk placement. You want to place your desk against the narrow wall of the room. This way it will take longer for the sound to reach its first reflection. Your listening position should be 33% away from the front wall. You do not want to be in the middle of the room, because that will cause an incredible amount of problems. Now that you set up your desk, we need to talk about monitor placement. Your monitors should make an equilateral triangle with your listening position. This means that the distance between the two tweeters and your listening position should be the same in order to create the most accurate stereo imaging. When we talk about the height of the monitors, your ear should be at the same level as the tweeter. Different monitors have the tweeter on different parts of the speaker. The Adams, as you can see, have it on top. So you either have your ears at the same height as the tweeter, or you have the tweeters pointing towards your ear. You also don't want any kind of obstruction between the tweeter and your ear. Now it's time to spend some cash. But don't worry, I've spent an enormous amount of money buying all kinds of different gear, so you don't have to. I am going to list in order of bang for buck the products that will make the biggest change in your home studio. Number one, monitor isolation. One of the most overlooked aspects of acoustic treatment, and for me, one of the most important. Putting a pair of expensive monitors straight up on a desk is like putting pineapple on a pizza. You can fight me, or you can just leave your hate in the comments. The low frequencies travel down through your speaker to the desk, making it vibrate, creating dissonant sound, especially if you don't have a sub. I've tried pads, pucks, and stands. Put them one against the other and found that the isoacoustic isolation stands give the best and most impressive result. They will really make your monitors shine. So I'm gonna give you two options. You can get the Auralex pads. You can put any kind of foam under your speaker, or you can put the money in the isoacoustic isolation stands. One of the most important pieces of gear in my studio. Now we're moving away from the desk because it's room treatment time. There are many options you can go with when acoustically treating a home studio. You can go for the classic foam, you can go for the built panels, or sites like Geek Acoustics have an option to buy a do-it-yourself panel, which will save you a lot of money. On this same site, and also on the Auralex site, they'll give you a free consultation where you can send them a sketch of your room with some pictures of it, and an expert will let you know what you need to make your room better. After this, you can either buy it from them or go to Amazon and buy some cheap foam there. Now that you know where to get your foam or panels, let's talk about the most important areas you need to take care of. Starting with bass traps. You need bass traps in your front corner, in your back corner, in your top front corner, and your top back corner of your room if you can. This will help control the low end frequencies that are the ones that cause the most trouble. If you have a lot of bass buildup, your room will shake and you won't be able to understand what's going on with your mix. Now that we separated our monitors from our desk and got rid of some bass buildups, let's move on to direct reflections. These are the areas the sound from your monitors hit first before they get to your listening position. In order of importance, the area behind your monitors, the area to the side and above your listening position. For all of these areas, you can get simple foam or panels. Now for the back wall of your room, that way, you should try to have a diffuser. A diffuser works by scattering reflections so nothing gets trapped and you can preserve the natural tone of the room. You can either buy one, build one. In my case, I have a bookcase that's very disorganized and, in my opinion, works just as well. Now that your room is acoustically treated, you need that last piece that will turn your listening position completely flat, making your mixes translate from your bedroom to every club around the world. You guessed it, we're talking about Sonarworks. Probably one of the elements that can really change your mixing tenfold. What Sonarworks does is create a corrective EQ made from you recording the sound that comes from your speakers in and around your listening position. So if you have any sort of notes or any sort of dissonances, you put this plugin on your master and it corrects them. Now, if you are rich as you can get the Genelex with AMS technology, which basically means that they have a Sonarworks built inside them. So this was my guide to the acoustic treatment of the small studio. All information I've gathered from countless hours of research and buttloads of money spent trying to make rooms sound better. I hope these help you out. If you have any sort of questions, make sure to leave them in the comments. And if you have any videos you would like me to make, do that too. Also, we got this new Broken English 2 t-shirts, Acid Techno Breaks with the acid smiley, that you can get right now, and it's for a good cause because I'm giving away all of the proceeds from these to a bushfire relief foundation. I'm still looking for one, so if you know one you trust, DM me. You can follow me here, here, and here. You can listen to my music here. Make sure to like and subscribe if you're into music production. I hope this helps you out. Take care.